Joining us now is Dwayne Gosin, and he, of course, is with the state of Kansas for many, many years and in several different capacities. Can you tell us your background, first of all, with the legislature?
Chris, I've served in the legislature for 14 years, have been budget director for Kansas for 12, and also served as secretary of administration for the last 6 or 7 years until this last December.
And you are now with the Kansas Health Institute. Tell us what that is.
The Kansas Health Institute has a mission of providing good, solid research and information on health policy issues to the legislature and other policymakers. It's an independent, nonpartisan operation which has operated in Kansas for about 20 years.
And really, you're going to do that for us now. You're going to be an impartial person with a lot of history with the Kansas legislature to talk about the budget and kind of the climate of Kansas right now.
That's right. Okay. I'm happy to be here, Chris.
Thank you so much. Are we in a recession right now, or how would you characterize where we are right now in Kansas?
We have been in a very difficult recession. In fact, the U.S. and Kansas are now climbing out of the most severe and long-lasting recession since the Great Depression in the 1930s. But we are climbing out. We aren't in recession anymore. We have been, but we are slowly inching our way back up.
And I think that was also stated by President Obama. He talked a little bit about it in the State of the Union address on January 25th. Let's take a look.
Now, we are poised for progress. 2 years after the worst recession most of us have ever known, the stock market has come roaring back. Corporate profits are up. The economy is growing again. But we have never measured progress by these yardsticks alone. We measure progress by the success of our people, by the jobs they can find and the quality of life those jobs offer, by the prospects of a small business owner who dreams of turning a good idea into a thriving enterprise, by the opportunities for a better life that we pass on to our children. That's the project the American people want us to work on. Together.
So are we poised for progress here in Kansas?
Yes. The recession really affected our revenues in a dramatic way. In a two-year period, our state income and sales tax revenues dropped by almost $1 billion. They were here, and then they, in a two-year period, dropped way down. But then as the recession ended and we started to grow again, those revenues have started to come back up. They're growing again. But they aren't yet back to where they once were. Our current revenue forecast is still lower than what we received 4 years ago. So while things are getting a little better and we're moving back up, we aren't yet back to where we once were. But as the economy improves, as consumer confidence and unemployment gets better, then our revenues will improve as well, and it will get back to a point where the economy produces enough money to fund services.
So when we were, when was Kansas at the bottom? When did it hurt the most?
Kansas went into the recession a little later than most states. But once we were in, it hurt pretty significantly. Economically, our lowest time was really in 2009, but that then translated into a very difficult budget year in what we call fiscal year 2010, the last budget year, last year. That was probably the most difficult budget year that Kansas has faced in many, many, many years.
So how is the budget set? Give us an idea of how the revenue is explained in the budget.
Kansas and most states fund their operations mostly with income taxes and sales taxes.
Okay.
For instance, in Kansas, income and sales taxes provide about 90% of our state general fund revenue. But in a recession, those sources of revenue are deeply affected.
No income. People don't have jobs, so they don't have the money to have an income to have the income tax taken.
Absolutely correct. As unemployment went up, as household income went down, as businesses pulled back, as consumers quit buying as much, then our income taxes and sales taxes were very directly affected. And as a result, the budget, in order to balance, had to be cut back. If revenue is here and it takes a big dip, somehow, to balance the budget, that dip has to be filled up.
Mm-hmm.
Over the last several years in Kansas, we've dealt with that budget gap by using federal funds from the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act.
The stimulus money.
Mm-hmm. Right. There have been some new sources of revenue. There's been a temporary sales tax enacted. And most significantly, there have been very deep budget cuts. Kansas has a history of dealing with budget problems head on. That goes way back. It's a practical state, and Kansans, I believe, like to have their budget balanced.
Right.
And as we've faced these recessionary problems, as our income has dropped, the state government has very directly dealt with the issue. And it's been hard, but for the most part, we've been able to get through this period with balanced budgets.
And that's a statute. We have to have a balanced budget.
We must. We must somehow make our income and our expenses line up.
Let's do a little comparison if we can. I have some numbers here from different states and where they are as far as financial deficits. California, $25 billion. Illinois, $15 billion. Louisiana, $1.7 billion. New Jersey, $10.5 billion. Texas, $13.4 billion. So how does Kansas compare?
Kansas is actually better off than most states. Even though there are some really hard decisions that we've had to take here in Kansas, this next budget year is actually a more difficult one in most places in the United States. Let me give you a couple of examples.
Mm-hmm.
In Kansas, our unemployment rate is normally 4 to 5% in a good time. During the recession, our unemployment rose up to a little over 7%. And has now dropped back to around 6.5. But nationally, unemployment at the height of the recession went up over 10% and much higher in some states, and now has dropped back to around 9%. But nationally, it's 9%. In Kansas, we're 6.5. So we're better off on jobs than most places in the U.S. And our budget shortfall, the difference between our income and what it costs to fund services, that shortfall is smaller in Kansas for this next year than it is in most states. I think by most estimates, the shortfall for this next year in Kansas is around 8 or 9% of our state general fund. But for most states, including the ones you mentioned, and you mentioned some of the worst ones, for most states, the shortfall is around 20% or higher.
What other pieces of information do you think that that those who are watching the legislature need to consider about how the session is going?
The biggest decision that legislators have this session is how to configure the budget, how to cover the shortfall between the amount of income that we have and what it really costs to have services. And there's a gap, there's a shortfall. And so the big debate is going to be on how do we cover that? What are the things that either are cut back or what is added in for revenue to make that shortfall disappear?
Compare Kansas budget's deficits to other states. We have fared fairly well.
In comparison to other states, we have fared fairly well. But the decisions here have still been difficult.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to make it seem like there have not been hard decisions. But compared to other states, Kansas is in a good position. And part of the reason for that is that the recession has not been quite as deep here as it has been for most of the country. And part of the reason is that Kansas and Kansas government dealt very directly with budget problems over the last 2 years, and that now puts us in a better position as we go forward.
Are we in a position for long-term growth? Because it seems as if each budget year, we get it fixed for that year. What about the long-term, so that every year isn't so down to the wire?
Well, it's important to remember that budgets are very cyclical things. And we go through periods of gain and periods of decline. And we had a very, very good period of time in the late 90s and leading up to a recession that hit us about 2003 after the 9/11 attacks. And then we had another very good period after that. And then we hit this recession. Now, we'll come out of this recession too. And we will begin gaining again. We already are gaining, but that will increase. And we'll come to a good time again. But it's important to take a longer view of these things, because if you only look year by year by year, it seems like, at least for these last several years, it seems as though things have been really difficult and hard. But we're going to come out of that and eventually get to a place where it's not as hard to fund services.
Is the state budget very different than a person's budget in their home?
Actually, it's really not very different. A person, any of us in our own homes, we've got a checkbook. We have to keep that checkbook balanced. And that's exactly how the state operates. We've got a checkbook. If there's a balance in the checkbook, it's possible to write checks. But if there isn't a balance, we can't. We have to make the income and the revenue match and line up. Just as every household does that, the state has to do that too. And that's why it's been difficult for the past few years, because the income has been cut off or cut down significantly. And that means that there just isn't as much money to go around.
Thank you so much, Dwayne Gosin. We appreciate you being here. Former Secretary of the Administration and State of Kansas Budget Director, we appreciate your background and giving us some history on Kansas.
Thanks. I've been glad to join you on the program.